Now it is 8:10. Maybe for half an hour,
yes,
we talk about statistics, and then we will revert to the understanding Six Sigma. See, I'm showing a ring of fire here, right? I'm showing a ring of fire. If I want all of you to jump inside the ring of fire, one by one, right? All of you have to jump inside the ring of fire one by one. And now tell me, where will you plan to jump? No, the ring is a circular one. And now tell me, which particular portion of the ring or which particular point in the ring you will prefer to execute your jump?
Center, sir.
Center.
Oh, beautiful. So, center. All of you would like to jump through the center. Why? You want to be safer, right?
Yes.
You want to be safer. So, center is the point which is far, far away from your risk, from your risky zone. What is
fire?
Risky? Yeah, the fire is risky. So center is the point which is, far away from the risk. So this is called a central tendency in statistics. This is called a central tendency in statistics. Similarly, any business process, you have to run your business process at a point which is far away from the risky zone. Which is far away from the risky zone. So how do you understand where are you operating your process? You can understand your process point. So before that, so when you have to jump inside the ring of fire several times, you can't jump it at the same point, repeatedly. Consistency will be a problem. So customer always will give some tolerance. So you have tolerance, and now you are jumping repeatedly. Suppose when the number of jump increases, let's say I want you to jump 100 times. Now what will happen? Few jumps you might come outside the white color circle. Suppose I increase the number further, maybe 1,000 times. Now what will happen? Few jumps you might make here also. Is it logical? When I keep on increasing the number of execution,
variation will be increases.
Variation will increase. This is called inconsistency. There are two things important. Where do you want to jump? And another thing is, how do you jump? Where do you want to jump? I get to understand from the central tendency. Central tendency will help you to understand where do you want to jump. One of the central tendencies is average. Similarly, how do you jump regularly? That can be understood by standard deviation, right? So these two will let you know. What is standard deviation? Standard deviation tells you how close or how far your values of the data in relation to the center. If you are far away from the center, deviation is more. If you are in the white color circle, you are close to the center. Now deviation is less. If you are in the yellow, you are far away from the center. That means your deviation is more. If you come to the orange, your deviation is more. So more deviation means more risk. Less deviation means less risk. And what we measure in standard deviation. This is the formula. Hope all of you have studied this formula, right? In your primary, the 7th standard or 8th standard, you would have studied. Sigma or summation of x minus x bar whole square divided by n minus 1. Under the square root, right? And now, how is this knowledge helpful to me? The average and then the variation. And you see here, I am showing a triangle here. And now there is a line here drawn at the center of the triangle. When I draw this line at the center of the triangle, do you see the triangle is getting divided into two equal parts? Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So that means the right side portion of the triangle is 0.5. That is 0.5. Now I remove one portion of the triangle. You see some graph behind. Now you remove the other side also. Now I am showing you a graph called the normal distribution. This is called what?
Normal distribution.
Can I now say the normal distribution is also symmetrical at the center?
Yes, sir.
This is an important property of a normal distribution. Whenever you see this kind of graph, you can consider this as normal if you see the graph symmetrical at the center. And one more thing, in the center you will always see the average. In the center you will always see the average. We'll understand that. And then when you move away from the center, now let's say I am here. Somebody tell me, what is my distance from the center?
Mu plus 1 standard deviation.
That means I moved away from the center by a distance equal to 1 sigma. I move further. Now I moved away by 2 sigma. And now I move further. Now I am at a distance of 3 sigma from the center. This point is called upper control limit. Point is called upper control. Looking on the left side, when I move by 3 sigma, this is called lower control limit. Always, in any normal distribution, when you find out upper control limit and lower control limit, 99.73% of the points will lie inside the control limit. What is that I am saying? 99.73% of the points will lie inside the control limit. This is true in your sample. This will be true in your sample if your sample follows normal distribution. If you collect the sample in a correct way, whatever you are seeing in your sample will be applicable to your population also. Your sample will be considered a correct sample if you collect the sample without committing measurement error and sampling error. Measurement error and sampling error. If you don't commit these two things, your sample will be the correct sample. And whatever way your sample is behaving, your population will also behave. So you will better understand this now. Imagine. So I have some table. So serial number. And then I am simply collecting your age. So all your ages are tabulated here. So just some rough value, 38, 39, 40 and something. Now I calculate the average, 38.5. Hope all of you know how to calculate average. Now deviation. What is deviation? X minus X bar. Distance of each point from the average. Can somebody tell me what is the distance of 39 from average? How much it is?
0.5.
Okay, no problem. So this is 0.5. I have found the deviation for all the points. I have found all the deviation for all the points. And now the total deviation is 0. I want to understand the deviation, but total deviation is 0. So I square each deviation. I squared it. Now the total deviation is 91.5. The total deviation is 91.5. Now what is the, on an average, what is the distance of each point from the average? For that purpose, I divide this value by n minus 1. Here n is 6. N minus 1 is 5. So what happened? 18.3. The 18.3 is called variance. The 18.3 is called variance. Now when I take the square root of the variance, that will give me the standard deviation. You see here, formula for standard deviation is square root of this. This is variance. So I take the square root of variance, I get the standard deviation. So when I take the square root, this is 4.27. Standard deviation is understood. I randomly picked up 6 people who are attending my white belt training program and their age is documented, or the age is recorded. I calculated the average age is 38.5 and standard deviation is 4.27. What is this average is telling me? The average is telling me when I get people attending my white belt training program, their age will be approximately 38.5. It looks logical because this sample I have taken from some white belt batch only. And so this knowledge I can apply for all my white belt batches. Maybe in a year, I will train about 1,000 people. Out of the 1,000 people, the average age will be 38.5. That means above 38.5, half of them will be above 38.5, half of them will be below 38.5. All right. So average will always divide your data into two parts. 50 on the right side, 50 on the left side. And then what is this standard deviation is telling me? Average plus 3 sigma will be my upper control limit. I calculate here. So upper control limit is 52.6. Lower control limit will be 24.4. I learned somewhere that if my data follows normal distribution, 99.73% of the data will be inside control limit. What are control limits here? 24.4 and 52.6. Now, is there anybody here not falling in this interval? Come on.
All are within control limit.
All are within control limit. So, if the sample is collected properly, sample will speak about your population. Am I right? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Sir.
This is the beauty of normal distribution. The more you understand about normal distribution, the more will be, you know, the predictability. All right. So average is a measure of central tendency or variation?
Central tendency.
Very good. And standard deviation is always a positive value. Is it true or false?
Sometimes negative also.
No, standard deviation is always positive, right? We square it and then we take it. So what proportion of points will lie inside your control limit?
99.73.
Yeah. 99.73% of the points will lie inside the control limit. Good. And now, is that all of you know what is specification limit and what is control limit? Control limit, I taught you, right?
Yes, sir.
What is specification limit?
What tolerance given by customer.
Wow, beautiful. And now we are going to compare the tolerance given by the customer and tolerance of the process. Tolerance of the process are nothing but the control limit. Right? Now, let me play a short video and then we'll talk about it. Elephant taking bath in a tub, right? And now tell me, can you comment about the experience of the elephant? Is it, is that the elephant is enjoying the bath or is it struggling a lot? What is your opinion?
It is struggling a lot.
You know what is the reason? Why is it struggling?
Tub is not sufficient space.
Able to fit inside the tub.
The tub size and elephant size are, you know, almost same. Same way your business might struggle if you keep the customer tolerance and process tolerance almost same. Right? If you keep the customer tolerance and process tolerance almost same, your business might also struggle. So you have to clearly understand what is the customer tolerance and what is the process tolerance. How do you know customer tolerance? You should know about the specification limit. How do you know process tolerance? You should know about the control limit. Control limits are nothing but the limits of your process that will give you an idea about the process tolerance. Plus or minus 3 sigma are called process tolerance. Right? And now, if you want to convert the challenge into a pleasure, what you are going to do is, I will increase the tub size here and then bring pleasure for the elephant. Similarly, to bring pleasure for your business, you can judge what needs to be done. I'll ask you that. And let us watch what happens. And the elephant is really enjoying the process, right? Why? Because the size of the elephant is smaller compared to the size of the tub. Similarly, you can convert your business into a pleasure by making sure your process tolerance is smaller compared to the customer tolerance. Because you really cannot change the customer tolerance. Here I changed the tub, but in your case, you can only work on the process tolerance. Am I right? So make sure.
Yes, sir. We cannot change customer
tolerance. We can't change the customer specification, but we can definitely control the control limit. So make sure your process tolerance or process control limits are, you know, shorter compared to the customer tolerance. This is almost similar to, you know, the size of the car and the parking area. And imagine you have a parking